There's a telling verse early in the book of Isaiah. One of those verses that makes you stop and think and sort of say to yourself, ooh, yeah. Isaiah 5 begins with God speaking of His vineyard. A vineyard in a very fruitful hill, He calls it. It's clear He's talking about His people Israel. And then in Isaiah 5:4, He says, what could have been done more to my vineyard that I have not done in it? What more could I have done for my people? You think the same principle applies today? Of course, God's world, God's church, however you'd like to apply this, God cares very much for. Do you think God has done everything He could possibly do for the blessing or the salvation of this world? No doubt about it. God isn't leaving anything undone. So when Jesus returns and people are either saved or lost, no one will be able to blame God if they're not saved. In most countries in which this is seen, everyone has access to the Bible. I can literally walk 5 minutes from where I'm standing right now and buy a Bible for $1. They're everywhere. In most countries where they're not so common, the Bible can be found online for free. Anyone who's never taken the time to read the Bible and find out what it's all about cannot blame God. There are churches in every town, tracts printed in just about every language. Every year there's Christmas reminding people that Jesus was born, and Easter proclaiming that God's Son died for the sins of the world. God has knocked on our door. You see a sunrise and a sunset and a kitten and a monkey and a flower and a butterfly and a whale and a bolt of lightning, and you can say, that came from nowhere at all. Or you could say, that's all due to evolution. Or, that was made by an intelligent God. There are Christians living their faith, prayers answered, blessings received. Most everyone has seen something miraculous that defies rational explanation. No one is going to be able to say, why didn't God do more to get my attention? People have heart attacks and live, cancer and survive, walk away from accidents, recover from strokes, and we want God to do more? There's only so much God can do. But there's one more thing. God doesn't just advertise Christianity, but He works through living, breathing Christians to show others what faith in God looks like, what God in a life looks like. Undoubtedly, God is looking to you to be that person, someone He can work through to reach out to someone else who hasn't yet been able to make sense of it all for whatever reason. So while God's doing everything He can to convince people that He is real, that He is love, that heaven is real, that everlasting life is free and accessible, He's looking to the church. He's looking to people of faith to be a living embodiment of what faith in God looks like. Why living connected to Him makes a good deal of sense. God asks in Isaiah, what more could I have done? He says the same today.